across the console and welcome Amy Rowe to the radio station. Amy, how are you?
I am doing wonderful, Barry.
For those who don't know, what is your official title?
It is the Executive Director of the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce.
Outstanding. You must have a chauffeur and a Cadillac with that kind of title.
I do, and a cabana boy.
Yeah, just the same
chocolate
way I do.
Chocolate covered strawberries.
When
I
you
know.
Find yours, you let me know where mine is.
I definitely will. Maybe somebody will provide that. Who knows?
So what's happening with the Chamber of Commerce these days?
Yeah, well, we're doing it on Tuesday. We're so grateful, you know, for y'all being flexible because I have to go to a seminar on Friday.
Ah.
I get to learn about communication, so go all the way down to Indianapolis. So today's our big day, and we'll have our board meeting on Thursday, but we had our executive board meeting yesterday. So
Okay. We've
got a big agenda coming on Thursday, things that we are attempting to finalize because we don't like to have a board meeting in December because we like to just have a little break and a little fun. So we're attempting to get all the big stuff taken care of so we can just do our board celebration at Snobbletier and enjoy our lives. The rest of December.
Excellent.
So, plus I have to have surgery again, so
Oh. That
adds a little extra bonus there for making December light and easy.
Yeah.
And Christmas.
That's always good.
Yes.
You don't want to be busy.
No. We're supposed to be able to enjoy the Christmas spirit, right?
Uh-huh.
Holiday spirit, the magicalness. So, we're working hard. So, we got coming up, one of the fun things that people will see in January is we've been working slowly to redecorate the office, which I know that's not a huge thing, but perception is king. And so if we invite folks outside and want to bring them into our office, we want it to be inviting and look like we're business professionals. And so we're actually getting a handcrafted desk. I know that sounds random, but we have a handcrafted desk that will be in the shape of something. I'm going to keep it secret.
Something.
But it will help to make the office look complete. It's something that everybody loves that's Fulton County based. So we are looking at doing that. And if you walk into the office now, you'll see all the logos because we're trying to clarify as to who's in that office and, you know, help everybody because that's one of the most confusing things. There's so many organizations and they're all housed in there. So we've got a fun statement from Henry Ford that Rapid View printed for us about teamwork. And then under that are the five logos of the organizations that are currently housed at 822. So little by little, we're creating a beautiful mecca of inviting business development so that
Excellent.
People can. I think that's part of it is that we don't always understand how important that is. But I had a friend when I first came here from South Carolina who he randomly visited. His first thing was, well, Amy, if you go up there, you might want to look at just updating kind of the look of things and the flow of things that might be helpful and attracting some business developers and, you know, more interest into the chamber. So we have spent 2.5 years working on getting that done because it just takes a little while. So we love that. We think it's beautiful, but that's the fun stuff. But now, you know, in November, we've got to look at policy and budgets and board members and officers. So we've got some good potential board members coming on and some officers.
Okay.
We have a gentleman from Woodlawn Hospital who was actually on the Elkhart Chamber Board. And he is now taking Dave Colger's place. And he's going to be sitting on our board, knock on wood, as the treasurer for us. And so he comes with experience looking at Karen McCoy, who was a former chamber director at Kokomo Chamber of Commerce, sitting as the vice president. And then Chris Wood would be the president. And then Kendra Chudinsky as the past president. So we've got a good lineup of individuals who will help us to.
A lot of experience there.
Yeah. And so I feel like it's perfect because we've worked really hard and we've gotten a lot of baseline things done, but I'd like to move us into completion of kind of our destiny and where we're going and our final strategic plan to try to get us to be where I feel like we need to be, where the board wants us to be. So, and then the budget, obviously, that's exciting, trying to figure out all those details and just had a sponsor visit with First Financial. So I walked from there over here, just looking to see who our sponsors will be and if they want to stay at the same level. And those are the all of our members are so important that, you know, obviously is essential, but the folks that provide the baseline, the meat of the budget are our sponsors. So we just look to see, do they feel like they got the value out of it? Is there anything else we can do for you? And so that helps to round out our budget. So I think we've got a good budget with some fun stuff. Maybe, Lord willing, everybody votes on it, a new website coming because it's a little outdated. And so just updating our look and putting the money that our members give us towards projects that actually will be valuable to everybody. So, okay. And then policy. Nobody loves that but me. I think that being able to have an organization that has guidelines is essential. Standard operating procedures. And so we haven't had a policy since, I think, 1985.
Really?
So, mm-hmm.
Wow.
I know. So they had a great policy then. It was wonderful. But now, since the organization has changed and evolved, it's time to make sure that we write everything down. And so...
It reminds me of a conversation I had when I was in college. A friend of mine was leaving for spring break. I said, "Where are you going?" He said, "I'm heading out west for an anarchist convention." I said, "How does that work? How do you organize an anarchist convention?"
They probably don't have policies.
I was going to say, do you elect officers? How do you do that? An anarchist convention.
They unelect officers. Each for his own, right? Whatever works for them.
Wow.
So,
but yeah. No policy for that long. Goodness.
Yeah.
Things have changed since back then, you think?
Yeah. True story. Well, and I think it was just because it was transitional. Obviously, when the organization transitioned, it became essential for that. And they've been spending the last few years really figuring out what that footprint will look like. So right now is the perfect timing. Before that, it would have been, I think it probably would have had to change too many times. But now we're getting to the place where we're settling into, you know, what is it going to be and how is it going to be? So right now is the perfect time, and it's taken a lot longer than anticipated. Yeah. Dear Lord in heaven. So we had to look at different templates and see what other chambers are doing and build that out. So my poor assistant is probably going to throw herself a party when the policy is actually voted for, and we'll do that in January. So get that up and running, and then in February we're going to have a retreat instead of our board meeting because we deserve to pat ourselves on the back for all the hard work that we've been doing. So,
well, now's a good time to do that because if you believe what everyone is saying, the entire economy's in a transition.
Mm-hmm.
We got a lot of jobs that are going to be coming in Indiana with the automation is going to create new ones and get rid of old ones and so forth and so on. So now would be a good time to have that in place if you're a chamber of commerce.
Well, yeah. And looking, you know, in 2018, one of the things that we're really looking at, we have a team that was just created through FCLA, is a young professionals group. And we have been attempting to figure out what other niche do we need to look into. We did women in business, obviously female leadership. That was a niche that everybody was getting into that others had not in the area. And then young professionals, that's so important because the 21st century jobs, the, IT and all of these other positions that we may or may not have, we need to figure out how can we create a climate where those young professionals want to come back home and or stay. And so we're going to be meeting with Fulton County REMC. They have some ideas with Kara, never can say her last name, but she successfully put together a team in South Bend and some other individuals and the folks that are on the team to look at creating a really neat group. So that's going to be something else that we add to our plate for 2018. So, and it's essential. Okay. It's essential for the sustainability of Fulton County. And like you said, business is changing. We need to figure out how to continue to stay abreast of what's happening. And we need the young talent because succession plans. We need people that we can actually put into those positions. And if we don't have the young folks, we won't be able to have folks to put in those positions. Right. So that's going to be a big challenge and take a lot of work, but we're pretty excited.
And they're the ones pushing a lot of the change.
They are.
They want an a la carte life.
Mm-hmm.
Basically. Yeah. People call it the Uber economy, but it's not just the economy. It's their entertainment. It's everything. They want to pick and choose. They don't want to be handed a table full of stuff and told to eat all of it. They want what they want.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, they're young, so they want what they want when they want it, which is now.
And it's, believe me, it's going to be fascinating, you know, because we've got, you know, we've got a mixed culture here. We've got some, you know, older folks who have been in business for a long time and a lot of wisdom. And then we've got some younger folks who have new ideas, and trying to mesh the two of that. It's like the multi-generational workforce. It's a multi-generational community. So figuring out how can we most effectively bring those two groups together and create a plan that makes the most sense and be, you know, hopefully a platform for that to happen at the chamber with the help of the FCLA group. So God only knows what that's going to look like, but I'm excited. We've got somebody from Tippy Valley that's on the team, somebody from RTC, myself, somebody that's from the Kiwanis Lake Bruce area, who's a young lady who works for Rochester Homes, and then a young man that works for Smith, Sawyer & Smith. So a whole plethora of different individuals with different vantage points. So a lot of good folks to figure out what that looks like. So,
Okay. Yeah. What do we have coming up for holidays?
For holidays, well, the Chamber doesn't do the holiday stuff, but the Rochester Downtown Partnership, the Promotions Committee, they are cooking up quite a little event. I was talking to Bettina Zabel. She's the lead for that. And she had to go before the Board of Works the other day. And so she was just letting me know what they're looking at. She's looking at ice sculptors and reindeer and carriage rides and carolers. Joyce Jones, I believe, is coming down with her ladies, and they're going to be dressed up and doing caroling. I just talked to First Financial. I just found this out today. First Financial is going to be having hot chocolate and coloring contest. So they're, I believe, handing out the initial flyers today, the team had said, to all the downtown businesses to let them know that something's going to be happening. Santa's going to be here. I mean, traditional stuff as well. And then I believe after that, they're going to build that out. They're meeting on Wednesday evening, and they're going to figure out all the details and hopefully get, you know, kind of a additional itinerary. But I think they're calling it the holiday, Rochester Downtown Christmas Holiday Stroll. So once all those details are finalized, and it'll get with everybody and let everybody know. But it sounds like it's going to be quite a fun little kind of almost Hallmark-y deal. So I'm excited. I'm excited to see what they're doing. And Bettina, we're so grateful for her. She stepped up, and she actually did marketing in Chicago. She was a marketing individual in Chicago, and then she moved here with her family. So she's pretty energetic, and she's got kids herself. So she wants to create some fun, memorable events, and she wants to make sure that it's for all ages. So they're also looking at potentially having food trucks and decorating the 9th and Main or Centennial Park, having some things for adults as well. Mm-hmm. So should Excellent. Be a fun time.
Excellent. What else do we have going on that you need to cover today?
Yeah, so basically keep your eyes peeled. We're trying to get all of our events for the 2018, all the dates out there ahead of time. That was my goal. That's been my goal for 2 years. Mm-hmm. Just so we can let people know with our legislative breakfast and our gala and women in business, business after hours. You know, we're hoping that if everybody knows ahead, then they can plan. So keep your eyes peeled for that. We do have confirmation that on May 4th, Lieutenant Governor Crouch will be here. So she's going to be the guest for our first Women in Business. She'll speak to a group at the library as we always do. So that's pretty exciting to have her come and talk about what partnership at a state level looks like. Mm-hmm. So all the ladies will be invited to that, and to be able to understand from her perspective how to manage partnerships and relationships in the business world. So that's pretty exciting. We think that's pretty neat. Looking at potentially having Mayor Milo, who transitioned into a position under the governor, doing workforce. So we're knocking on wood that she's available in August to come speak about what she's doing for workforce development for the state of Indiana, because she's been tasked with addressing workforce development and all the issues related to that. So we're hoping that she'll come out next year in August to give us an update. She was here the first year, and she was a speaker. So hopefully she'll be a repeat for us and give us some good update and relevant information. So lots of fun things that we're looking at, and lots of planning and organizing, and we're all going to need a vacation. That February retreat should be in Mexico, but I don't think we have enough money for that one.
Good luck with that.
I know. So, but yeah, you know, continuing to work with tourism. Obviously, that's still under the umbrella of the chamber at the moment, but working on the trailhead building still and the tourism videos. I saw the first draft of one of them, and it's going to be pretty. My dad actually saw it, and he goes, "Is that a commercial?" And I said, "Yes, that's a commercial for Fulton County." He goes, "For Fulton County? That's Fulton County? And I said, yes, it is. It's Fulton County. And so Landon Smith has been working to video, to provide five tourism videos for us. And then one that's for Fulton County. And those would be pretty neat. So
excellent.
Yeah, to share our story so we can let the world know who we are.
Don't be afraid to put that up on our Facebook page.
Yes, everybody, it's available to everybody. So once they're complete, we want, you know, I think the hotels are going to put it there, the airport. You know, we're hoping that RTC will be able to potentially do it. So, yeah. So it's been pretty exciting. Lots of fun stuff, lots of projects. I feel like my desk has a lot of projects that I'd like to pack away and complete, but we're still working on them. So hopefully by mid-2018, all those projects will be neat and tidy in a little bow, and we can move on to the next level. But it feels like that never happens. But at least I always say, as long as we're making 1 centimeter progress every day on each project, I feel happy about it. So, but yeah, lots of good things coming. And like I said, the Rochester Downtown Partnership, pretty excited about their holiday stroll. I think it will be a fun event for the kids, for everybody, and to provide some excitement for downtown. So December 1st is when that is.
December 1st, okay.
So, yep, but keep tuned because I know that they're going to meet and probably get all of the information out to everybody, but little teaser on all the excitement, what it's going to be.
Excellent.
So, yeah.
Again, speaking with Amy Rowe of the Fulton County Chamber of Commerce. Amy, do we have anything else we need to go over?
No, I think we're good. Got a lot of fun stuff. And
thank you very much for your time.
Thank you so much for having us.